another project for you. Well, I wouldn't say it's a project, it's more of an unboxing. What I'll do to the Timrover RV channel, I'll try to bring you guys periodic unboxings of different things you can use for your RV. Today, I'm gonna be unboxing a countertop, tabletop, if you will, Igloo Ice Maker. Inside of Timrover, there is an ice maker, but I don't use the ice maker that's built inside.
RV park,
you're not for sure. I don't drink the water, as in consuming the water from different RV parks, because I've seen a lot of water that's totally yellow. You're not for sure if it's good water for you or not, let alone the bottles that we have, like Aquafina and Nestle and other makers.
I try to
stick with bottled water, even though this might not be the best thing for you as well. I could go to Voss water in the glass bottles, but I don't want to do that either, just because Voss water gets kind of expensive as well after time, over time, I should say. I do have a water quality test kit and that I use periodically, I should say, but you just don't know what the water you're drinking. So I'll just stick with these plastic bottles for right now and try to consume as fast as I possibly can, because when they're stuck inside this plastic, the chemicals from the plastic kind of bleeds off into the water. RV Habit also, another subscriber, I'll put a link above. RV Habit, he also did a demonstration on his Magic Chef countertop, tabletop ice maker as well. I'll put a link above, you guys can check him out, do maybe a comparison of the ice maker that's out there. They have different sizes for your countertop, because you guys know, inside of a RV or any rig, no matter how big it is, countertop space is a total premium, so you want to be kind of careful of the size of the ice maker that you get. I just hope that this ice maker is not too big for the countertop space inside of Timrover. So let's go ahead and unbox this here. I'll show you the ins and outs and how you can make your own ice inside of your RV if you don't have an ice maker. So I'll go ahead and take my knife. Just be careful not to cut yourself. I'll take my blade here, or knife, and I'll go ahead and just score it like so. Cut the top here. And I'll open this here up. So what I'll do, I have my instructions right here. Comes in different pamphlets, limited warranty, probably out of my warranty because I bought it late last year. But anyway, that's your instructions, and what we'll do, I'll go ahead and flip this back like so, and we'll just tip this over. Be careful not to damage it. Lift the box up. We'll give you the bottom section of this Igloo. We'll turn it back over.
So now, just be careful
that we have this open, we can take the styrofoam off like so. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to go ahead and take a break. I'm going to read the instructions to see how it works, and then I'll come back and show you guys how to operate this ice maker. What we have here, you have your evaporating fingers. I can kind of glance in here and show you. You got 9 fingers in here that basically the ice kind of molds onto these fingers here. And you have your max seal indicator inside. It's kind of opaque, but actually is embedded inside the plastic. And on the bottom, you have your drain plug for alleviating excess water that you don't use when it's not in use. On the left-hand side, you have your fan. And of course, lastly on the back, you have your plug here, along with your serial number and other information about the unit itself. I have my Aquafina bottles here. We use this here as an example. And what we're going to do, we're going to lift the lid up. And basically, we're going to open each bottle. I'm just going to pour water in. And just keep pouring. Lay that to the side. Just keep pouring. This would be kind of a good idea if you can kind of test out to see how many bottles of water this particular unit takes.
Pour in
to the max line here, like so. I'm not for sure if this is going to make 26 pounds of ice, but we'll see how many bottles of water it do take. So far, I've used 3 bottles. This is the 4th bottle of water, and I'll fill it up to the max line. It looks like it might take maybe another half bottle. So now we've used four bottles plus this one here. So I'll take it to the max line fill. And that's not even basket back in, like so. And I close the lid and we'll plug her up and we'll see what happens. Inside of here, there's those little fingers we talked about earlier. They're actually getting cold and they're sitting inside of this ice maker. You have these little pellets in which I'll take one out. It looks like a piece of a test tube, and it's making more ice as we speak, I should say. And it's like a little hollow hole. But what I recommend, if you have something like this here, if you want to purchase this here, get an ice bucket. This ice bucket I've used inside of Timrover. I use it for basically holding ice because, like I mentioned earlier, there is an ice maker inside of Timrover, which I don't use the ice maker at all. But this is a great project, and I'm glad I opened the box up to show you guys how it looks. Thanks to RV Habit, I'll put a link up this channel as well. You guys can check it out. But like I said, do me a favor, if you get this here, get an ice bucket. Immediately put the ice that you have in here in a bucket back in the freezer of your refrigerator, because what's going to happen if you don't do that, this is going to recycle itself and turn into water again, because this is not actual a freezer, just an ice maker. So think about that as well. Maybe a con, maybe a pro. I'm not for sure if you like it here or not. But do me a favor, give me a thumbs up if you like for checking this out. Hit the subscribe button as well, and I bring more episodes of tips, tricks, ideas for Timrover RV that you guys can check out. If you have an idea, shoot me an email. I'll try it out. We'll see what happens on one of the episodes down the road. You guys take care. Have a good day. Bye.